Hi everyone, welcome back to Growing Your Indoor Garden. Today I'm going to talk about a very common problem if you grow indoors, and that is dealing with fungus gnats. Now if you don't know what fungus gnats are, they're those teeny tiny little flying insects that sometimes you see hovering around your plant, especially flying up when you water. But don't be deceived, they're usually not just on the surface of your plant or flying around your plant. Many times the larvae are eating away at the roots of your plant, really affecting your plant's growth and your plant's health. So today I'm going to share with you three ways that you can deal with fungus gnats, a couple of them using some products you already probably have around your own house. Fungus gnats get their name not because they spread fungus, but because they feed on fungus. And we all know that fungus thrives in a humid, moist environment. So preventative measures always work best. So just make sure that you don't overwater your plants. Now, some symptoms of fungus gnats, besides the obvious, seeing them fly around your plants, are just a general lack of growth. Your plant just doesn't look very vigorous. The leaves might be yellow, kind of like these cucumber leaves here. They're not like super dark green like I would really like to see. And I have had some fungus gnats in my grow light closet. I've gotten rid of pretty much the ones on the surface, but I'm thinking there might be some eating away at the roots. So let me tell you a few tips that I like to do to, number one, help prevent fungus gnats, because that's always the best way to go, but then how to control a fungus gnat outbreak. Well, the first way I like to deal with fungus gnats is by dealing with the ones that are flying around. So super easy to do using something you probably already have on hand, and that is apple cider vinegar. So this is super easy to do. First of all, you would just want to find a couple of shallow containers around your house. This is just a little tea light holder and then a lid from a bottle that I was just going to throw away. So I've got a couple of these and just want to shake up my apple cider vinegar. These are going to be like little fungus gnat traps. Pour it in my shallow container here. Pour a little bit in my lid. Okay, and then I want to put a drop of dish soap in each one. Just one little drop is good enough because this breaks the surface tension and the fungus gnats will fly in and they won't be able to get out. So I'll just kind of shake it up a little bit and then I will put this around where I have my plants. What I like to do is just make up several of these fungus gnat traps and just set them around my house right near where I'm growing my plants. Now you want to make sure you check it every couple of days because the apple cider vinegar will evaporate. Once it evaporates, what I found is the fungus gnats come swarming back. So you want to make sure you stay on top of it and that way it doesn't get out of control. The second way I like to deal with fungus gnats is with a simple neem oil spray. Now, I've used neem oil both indoors and out for several years. It's very effective against chewing and sucking insects if it contains a component called azadirachtin. Now, just be aware, much of the neem oil you see in the garden centers is highly processed and doesn't contain azadirachtin. So I get mine from Gary over the Rusted Garden. I know a lot of you guys watch his channel as well. He's got some great tips over there. But his is 100% cold pressed neem oil, does have the azadirachtin in it, and I found it to be very effective. So I'll put a link up on the screen to his website where you can get it, and I'll also pop that down in the video description. So what I've done is mixed up a neem oil spray, quart of water, teaspoon of neem oil, a couple of drops of dish soap, and you want to shake it up really well because the dish soap will help the neem oil disperse through the spray and will also help it stick to your plants. So the first thing I'm going to do is just spray the leaves here of this plant with the neem oil. That'll take care of the insects that are flying around. I'm also going to spray the soil surface, and I'm also going to spray the soil container itself and the bottom of the container to help take care of the larvae. Now when you're starting seedlings, ideally you just want to spray the bottom of your container before you even put your peat pellets in or your seed starting soil in. So you spray the bottom of that, spray all around the sides, and can even spray the bottom of your peat pellets if you're using peat pellets to help control the problem before it gets out of hand. And when you're spraying your plants with anything, it's always a good idea to do a test spray first, then wait 48 hours to make sure there's no adverse reaction before you spray all your plants. Now, I like to spray every 3 days for about 2 weeks when there's a problem, but use it as a preventative measure and spray before it gets out of control. Well, the third really common household item I like to use to help control fungus gnats is cinnamon. Cinnamon has antifungal properties, and when you use it on the soil, helps prevent fungus from growing that the fungus gnats feed on. They also are repelled by the scent, and it really helps control them on the soil surface. So it's very easy to do. I like to do it right when I plant my seedlings. And all you have to do is just sprinkle it over the surface of the soil. Whoops, you really just need a light sprinkling. That way when the fungus gnats land on it, they'll be repelled by it and they'll fly away, hopefully into your little fungus gnat traps. So there you go, right on the surface of the peat pellets. You can also do it after you've planted. Let's see, I think here you might have a little bit sprinkled, but you can just sprinkle it right on the surface of your soil and that will definitely help as well. Well, there you have it. Three easy ways for controlling fungus gnats so your plants can be nice and strong and healthy. Please comment below. Let me know how you've controlled fungus gnats with success and how your indoor garden is doing. And make sure you subscribe so you don't miss any future updates. Thank you so much for watching. We'll see you on the next video.